Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. So guys, as you can see in this video, I'm just going through, this is my last video in this topic, VMware. And in this video, I'm just, you know, concluding entire thing, whatever I have spoken so far in this training. And I will give you the basic idea what and all we had configured so far throughout the training. And as you can see here, this is my infrastructure. Once again, I'm telling you what and all I have configured. I had used five virtual machines throughout my infra. So I had one Active Directory, one vCenter server, two host, and one SAN server. SAN server. So I have already spoken about how to deploy this, each and everything. So this is just last video of this series, and next video I'll be talking about. Next video will be my on advanced, training in Server 2019. This is what I have, my basic infrastructure. So let me show you this is my host too, as you can see here, the IP and all. I have already shared all the details in my previous videos, and it is mentioning here. And I have one more virtual machine where my vCenter is deployed, one ESXi host is deployed, this is Active Directory, and this is SAN server, SAN iSCSI server I had deployed. And let it come back, this login window. So again, I'm telling you, each host require 4 GB. okay, if you are using 6.7, so you should give 4 GB RAM. And if you are using this embedded installation of vCenter, then you should give at least 10 GB RAM to your vCenter server, because it will install each and everything on one server only. Else you can use two server to install partially, like services and role on another single server. So in that condition, you can install 5 GB RAM. But if you are going with only one server, then use at least 10 GB RAM. And for this iSCSI, 1 GB is enough. For Active Directory, we don't use this much because it is required only for name resolution, DNS, to configure a couple of things. Like, let me show you here. You need to configure a couple of things in DNS, okay, like reverse lookup zone, forward lookup zone. So you should know. So guys, this is my Active Directory. Okay, I'm showing you my DNS entries because it is required. DNS is very important for virtualization. If you are working in VMware, and let's wait to come this interface. Okay, this blah 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 will come, and then it's giving blah blah only. Okay. So wait for server manager to come. Okay, this is server manager here. We can go to server manager, and till the time, let me see if that is coming up or not. Okay, it came up, and here we'll have couple of problem. Like before you open your this thing vCenter server console, you should run couple of services. Let me go back here. Okay, dashboard came. Let me go to tools, and DNS. Here is my DNS. Just click on this, and at the same time, let me go this side. It is giving some problem. Okay, let's see what is this hanging too much today. So let me minimize it. Okay, I will work like this only. So this is my vCenter. And let me go to Active Directory. So as you can see here, I am inside my DNS manager here. Okay, and this is my lookup zone, reverse lookup zone. So here you will have to create like this one primary. And like this it should be. So it will create all the records here. Okay, and for that what you need to do, you need to create like this. Let me show you this process. I think I have not shown you in my previous video. So you just need to click like this. Next, reverse lookup zone. This is not forward lookup zone. And click primary. And you can select whether you want for forest or you want for domain. So I'm using for domain only. And click next. And give IP version 4. And here you will have to assign your network ID, just like 192.168.0. And just click next and finish it. And hit 192.168.0. Okay, it will take 3 IDs only. Okay, so you just need to hit next and it will create. And it will ask for like you want to allow the dynamic update or not. So you can choose whatever you want and click next and finish. So it will create like this. Okay, and as you can see here, couple of entries made automatically. I had created that only, that this zone only. And similarly, we should create couple of entries here for all the you know host what we have. Like this is host 1, host 2, iSCSI, and vCenter for name resolution. So this is a basic information you should configure on your DNS server. Apart from this, nothing. And let me go to this now vCenter server and I will show you. So here, if go to vCenter server and type IP address 192.168.0. What happened? Nothing came. Okay, this is my IP address of my vCenter server. So it is not coming. So the reason is there will be couple of services stopped. So you should go to services from here. Okay, tools. So these are the challenges what we face while dealing with this and services. So here you will have to run couple of services, restart couple of services. So as you can see here, like first of all you should check this background intelligence service bits. Okay, so it is stopped from this running this service. And now you should check vCenter service only itself. So vCenter itself down, you should enable. And there are a couple of services, all VMware related services are down here. All services should be active from here to this much information. And apart from this, you should enable or restart couple of services. I will show you here in my video. One video I have explained about it already, how to troubleshoot this problem. So as you can see here, all down. Okay, so guys, it is going little lengthy. I'm pausing this video. Once that console is ready, I will continue. So guys, I have restarted couple of services and it is came. So I'm just going with this client. Okay, HTML. You need to restart couple of services from here to fix that error. So I have done lots of services and just going to console now. Let me log in. Oh, it is taking time a bit. So guys, I have logged in here. Okay, this is you know, default dashboard of this. So as you can see here, it is telling you manager license. So we are using this as an evaluation version. So it is telling like this. You can just close it, and you know, it is showing here once again. I'm telling you like who logged in here, which user, and this is your, you know, VSphere client. If you click here, it will give you all the details. Like this option tells you host and clusters, what and all you configure, VMs and you know templates you configure, storage will give information about from here. This is networking. So these are the core of this. Okay, and content library, global inventory list, you can check from here. So you can go like this. So I'm not going in detail. Okay, same thing is available here, this cluster, host, and this is shortcut. And if you click home, so it will take you home. Okay, and this will give you the basic you know idea about what kind of, I mean, how much storage you have, CPU utilization, memory utilization and all, and virtual machines, host here, as you can see this side, and installed plugins, object with most alerts, couple of things if you click on host. So here basically, if we want to create any host like ESXi host, then you will have to use this. So this is your domain added. So it is telling you like vCenter. This is machine name, and this is india.com is my domain. I had created one data store here, data center. So you can create any data store if you want to create, or any folder you want to create. So you have couple of things you need to assign license, then you will have to use this you know option. And if you want to add permissions, you can add couple of permissions from here to user. You can select users. Okay, so I'm not adding any, I'm just giving basic idea like local user or domain user or this local computer user. So you can define from here. So I'm not doing this basic idea. And this is your data center. Okay, so inside the data center you can create couple of, so if you click on this, okay, vCenter server, so you can see couple of things. Like this is your monitoring or summary basically. So you can see what is the status as of now, how much RAM RAM is running or utilizing. This is your monitoring. You can monitor from here all issues or triggered alarms, task, events, session, each and everything about your machine basically. And this is configuration. You can do couple of configuration, licensing and authentication, proxy if you want, advanced settings. And if you can see a couple of things here, vSAN you can configure from here. And this is permission once again, and like you know, this is your data center. So one data center only I have. This is again telling you host and clusters here, and this is your virtual machine. Okay, and templates and all. So as you can check all the things from here. And this is like data stores, how many data stores we have created, and it will give you networking and linked vCenter. This one, click this. Okay, so if you need to do any networking, like you need to create distributed switches, you will have to use this, or distributed port group, uplink port group. So each and everything I have already discussed in my previous videos. So let me give you a little bit more info about it. So if you go to this one, like you know default, and if you click host and clusters, you will find two hosts. Okay, one host is here, ESXi host 1 and ESXi 2 I have created. For that you just need to right click and add host, and if it is in your network, you can add that host. And if you want to create any distributed switch, you will have to use this option. So I had created distributed switch here. This is my pro cluster basically. It is telling you cluster. And if you go to networking, and if you go to networking basically, so it is coming this production D switch. So it will give you all the detail how to create and all. From here you can create. And if you want to go to particular, let me go to host only. So like this you can go to particular host, and inside that like you can see summary again, monitor again. This is configuration. Configuration will give you couple of information, like you will have to create couple of you know, storage adapter for connecting to your SAN servers, SAN storage server, so you can create. Then you will have to mount from here all the disk available on that particular SAN server. So as you can see here, like you know, this is disk available, LUN basically we call it, and this will give you path. Okay, and this is just basic networking, basic thing you have to do. And apart from this networking, you will have to create couple of switches for vMotion, distributed switch, and multipathing. So you will have to create couple of switches. So as you can see here, this switch is created for vMotion, and this is the configuration I had done in my previous videos. And there will be couple of, you know, default switch. This is my switch 0. That is for VMware network management, and I have one more switch, which is my ESXi host multipathing switch. So how to do it, all those things I have already uploaded separate videos you can use. And you sometime you need to create VM kernel. This is what I have created already. So you will have to use this option apart from this again, like, you know, TCP configuration manager, physical adapter management, you can do it from here. Licensing, couple of things you can do it from here. Okay, each and everything is not possible for me to cover, so I'm just giving you basic idea. And now you got one, you know, so this is what I wanted to show you guys. And this is like again permission and all, virtual machine data stores. Data stores means LUNs, what we create on NAS server, SAN server. And this is network. So again, now if you want to create like, you know, you need to add any virtual machine on this data this host. So you can right click, you can create new virtual machine, you can deploy OVM template, you can create template also if you go to, you know, template from here. So let me give you the brief idea about this only. And maintenance mode, you can go to maintenance mode from here, you can disconnect this host from here, and you can reconnect. Power, you can, you know, shut down, reboot. Certificate, you can renew and refresh certificate, authority certificate. And storage, you can check from here, you can create new data store, you can scan and add, you can add networking, and same thing you can do from this side also. So these are the basic things. And if you want to go to setting, you can go, if you want to move it, you can move from here. And if you go to setting, just you can go and let's see, the same thing will come. Okay, nothing fancy. So this is the basic idea about host configuration, what and all we can configure. Now, as I told you, if you want to create any virtual machine, you will have to use this option. Now, if you, this is the virtual machine what I had created. So if you just go to, you know, if you want to create any, again, you can do couple of things from like power off, suspend, reset, and take a snapshot or manage a snapshot, delete all the snapshots. And you can migrate this virtual machine from one data store to another data store. Couple of things, migration I have explained in my previous videos. Clone, if you want to create clone of this virtual machine, you can use this option, like clone to virtual machine, clone to template, or clone to template temporary. So you can use this option. And apart from this, like if you want to enable turn on fault tolerance, you can use this option. Okay, so I just clicked on that, it was not enabled, so it is coming some error. I will see later on that, about that. And apart from this, you know, a couple of policies you can apply on VMware, like this you can check from here, like SAN default policy, VM encryption policies, V volume no requirement policy. So I'm going with this only, so I'm not enabling any policy, I'm just telling you. And apart from this, couple of more things you can do from here, like you can template, I told you, compatibility you can check, schedule. And again, if you want to manage any setting, you can rename it, you can do couple of, you know, add permission, move it. And if you go to setting, so you can see here what and all setting I have done, like CPU, you can increase memory, you can increase hard disk space, you can increase the size SCSI controller, and network adapter you can change, drive you can change. Okay, and couple of more things, if you go to other, you will see here lots of things about it. And you can add even certain devices from here to this machine. And we have VM option here. like general option, VM remote option you can control from here, encryption, power management, virtual VMware tools. Okay, so guys, these are the, you know, couple of things you can manage from here. Now these are the basic information. For example, now if you want to create any cluster, okay, so again you will have to use this option. You will have to go to wait, this is for data center, this is for new folder, and for cluster, if you want any cluster, you will have to, the concept of cluster is very simple. For example, if you want to, you know, make two virtual machine as a single virtual machine, they should work as a single virtual machine to avoid fault, I mean this thing, downtime and all. You can use that clustering. Okay, so this is my cluster I had created. Here you can go to new cluster and you can add host and all. You can enable couple of services like DRS. So if you go to property of the cluster what I had created, I will show you this. This is the cluster what I had created, and go to setting. So as you can see here, fully automated, this DRS automation should be enabled. So it will check from which data center, that data store or host, basically from which host this virtual machine should run if anything is any issue is there. Okay, so this is the couple of things we have in this, and I have already enabled. So I'm just showing you can see, like, you know, let me show you just small things here. You can monitor from here, or you can go to host inside this. So again, it will give you host, virtual machine, network configuration, monitor. And if you go to monitor, you can check from here, like, you know, fault you can check from here, history you can check from here. So if it is not showing anything, you just run it. You can run it, okay, and it will take some time to collect the data, and it will reflect here, like this thing, memory utilization, from which machine it is taking memory. There is no memory consumption by virtual machine at this time. Okay, and this is like it is not using any memory from host one. It is using memory from host two only. Similarly, you can check CPU utilization. Okay, so guys, these are the basic information you should know if you are dealing with virtual, I mean this VMware environment. And this is what I'm just trying to cover in this, guys. Nothing fancy in this. Licensing you can put from here, and administration you can do couple of things from here, like, you know, like if you go to global inventory list, so again it will tell you a couple of things, like it is a list only. Okay, this is distributed choice, distributed port, group, network, data centers, cluster and all information, basic information. And this is policy and profiles. And apart from this, this is administration. You can add couple of, I mean, you can create couple of user here, and you can assign global permissions here, and solution like vCenter server extension and all. And this is users and group. Again, you can add, you can give permissions from here. Configuration, you can go configuration. This identity store is used to, you know, add Active Directory here. Okay, then only your Active Directory user will be able to log in and manage. So I have already done it in my previous videos, first or second videos, so you can check from there. And this is certificate management. You will have to assign IP address, username and couple of things, log in and manage the certificate. So guys, this is the basic scenario and last video of this series, my virtual VMware. So I hope this video will be informative, and if you feel, and if you want to learn something more, don't forget to subscribe my channel. In my next video, I'll be talking about, you know, I will start the advanced configuration on server 2019 step by step, one by one, from the introduction to take till the end, as much as I can tell you, somewhere around 30 to 35 videos. So guys, till then, bye bye, have a nice time, and good luck for your VCP, virtual, I mean this VMware work and career.